Elohim's name.
Elohim.
Yes. Okay. So Jesus never used a name which is Yahweh. Yahweh is
in the Hebrew was saying.
You know, I'm speaking to you, not him. So I'm saying he used the term Elohim, which is similar in Arabic language, Ilahi. Yes, similar. Elohim, Ilahi, similar.
Similar meaning not the same.
Okay. So why is the person hospital?
Anyway,
What is the difference between hospital and hospital?
No, listen, my foundation anyway.
No, ask me that. Sorry. Ask them, yeah, please. What's your name? Sorry, I forgot your name.
Sorry, I'm just
okay.
Going.
Okay, no problem. Christians, they don't like the names. One paper boy, one. Okay. What is the difference between hospital and hospital?
It's not relevant to me.
It is because Elohi and Ilahi is the same thing but different pronunciation. Just as we say hospital and okay. A hospital.
I have to give a reason why. I'm claiming no, we don't serve in the same God.
Now, you and the Jewish people, you don't serve the same God.
Yes, we do serve the same
God. That's the Jewish people believe Jesus God.
Yes. Okay. The Matthew, listen, John, Matthew, the Mary, all these were Jew. Why not?
No, wait.
Step I'm by, asking you.
Step by step.
Where then?
I've got to come to it.
Yes, okay.
Can you show me in the New Old Testament where the Israelite prophet called Jesus? Said Jesus God.
But I'm saying to you. Those who follow Jesus, those who were with Jesus at this time in Israel were Jews. Yeah, they follow him. The one he called the 12 disciples, they all were Jews. They were not Gentiles.
Mark and Matthew, they were not with Jesus.
They were with Jesus.
I understand that, but I'm asking about in the Old Testament, does the Israelite prophets say Jesus is God?
Does the old prophet? The old prophet, the prophet in the Old Testament.
Yes.
Those are the ones who reveal Jesus.
No. Okay, show me in the Old Testament where they say Jesus is God.
No. They call him. Anyway,
you're struggling. You are struggling.
Isaiah 9. Says, his name shall be called
Emmanuel.
Mighty God.
Yes.
Which is mean Mighty God.
Yeah.
So the prophet already from the Old Testament, they were referring who he is going to be.
So
he will be called Mighty God.
And yeah? Emmanuel.
Exactly.
Emmanuel.
So Mighty God.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. So
step by step. So in this Isaiah, he will be called Emmanuel.
Emmanuel.
Can you show me in the New Testament where Jesus being called Emmanuel? His mother called him Emmanuel.
That's what I'm explaining to you. You asking me from the Old Testament.
Yeah, because you.
If
I show you that it's not for Jesus.
No.
It's not about Jesus.
It is for Jesus.
No problem. So he'll be called Emmanuel, correct?
That's why when we go in Matthew, yeah, you see there was a man who never died, was waiting for the salvation of Israel. What is his name? I forgot. But he saw Jesus, he held the baby. And he says, he gave thanks to God. Now, Father, I've seen your salvation. Let your servant go.
Can you show me where Jesus called Emmanuel in the New Testament?
You asked me first on Old Testament.
I understand that. So you called
yes,
Old Testament.
I answered.
So I'm going to show you.
Hear me out.
I'm going to show you that prophecy is not about Jesus.
No, it is about Jesus.
I'm going to show you.
Allow me to finish my point.
In the New Testament, Jesus' mother never called him Emmanuel. And in that prophecy said he'll be called the everlasting father. Is Jesus the father or the son?
Jesus is the son.
So therefore he cannot be the same person that Isaiah is speaking about.
When the prophet spoke, they spoke in a language.
Okay.
In a language.
Yeah.
That was to reveal things. Let some people to understand. They could understand some certain things, but certain things they could not understand until the fulfillment. So when he talks about the everlasting Father,
yeah.
Which is meaning he was talking about the spirit of the Father being in him.
That's your explanation.
Of that person.
That's your explanation.
Which is
what's subjective, which is many scholars accept that, okay?
Yeah.
Even a Christian accept that. But no. He will be called Emmanuel, yes. Everlasting Father.
Yes.
Historically speaking, Jesus' mother likewise his disciple, they never called him everlasting father, they never called him Emmanuel. So my point here is
that,
according to the Old Testament, that we see clearly that Jesus has not been mentioned, and let alone to be called to be God. So here, the Jewish, the Israelites, they never believed that the same God you believe in. You believe in a different God completely.
No. Let me answer. What I'm saying to you, I talked about the spirit of the Father being upon him. Again, the same Jesus confirmed
that.
Jesus confirmed that. That's why when he's speaking to the people, he said, "Who sees me? As you can see me, you've seen the Father."
So your father is black.
I'm telling about
your father has a nose.
No, that verse from Isaiah.
And has eyes and mustache.
I told you. It's about the spirit of the Father.
I can't see his spirit.
Yes, you can't see it. Because
if you tell me, if you see me, see the Father, I'm going to look at as outside, not inside.
Yes, but just hear me. Hear
so
me.
I'm so the Father looks like a Palestinian
I'm talking
Jew.
About the spirit of the Father. When he claims in Isaiah 9, it will be called the multi God.
Yes.
It's the spirit of God will be upon him. That's why even Jesus, when he was talking to the Jew, he says, "Who sees me, sees my Father. Who hear the voice of God."
Is that correct?
It is correct.
So let me understand it correctly. Now, if I tell you, if you see me, you see the Father, you see my Father, what do you think I mean?
Which is mean, I have the nature of God in me that's speaking to you. That what you're saying, it's of God.
So, from my outside, yes. Your nature of God, that your God has a mustache and a big beard.
No, that's a human understanding now.
Yeah, but I can't, so hear me out. Listen.
Because
no one can
see God.
Hear me out.
In a physics, no one can see God and live again.
Allow me to finish my point.
Yes.
My point is, I cannot see what is inside you, correct?
No, in the human eyes, you can't see.
The only thing that I can see is what is outside,
yes,
correct?
Yes.
So when Jesus was telling his disciples, or the people, if you see me, you see the Father. If you see me, was he referring to himself, seeing him from outside or inside?
No, he was seeing in the own nature.
From inside or outside, let me understand it.
He was the nature of God.
I understand that.
In the physics.
So Jesus and the Father, both of them has a mustache and a long beard.
That's a silly argument I don't like about it. Because that's a mockery.
I'm not. Listen carefully
that's
to me.
That's a mockery.
Okay, correct my it's understanding. Correct my understanding.
Yeah, but that's kind of a naivety
when
the way you put in the
hear
question.
Me out. When Jesus said, if you see me, was he referring to him from outside looking at him or looking at him from inside?
From inside.
But I cannot see inside.
Not that physical form,
yes,
that he was. A person just like
but
me.
But you just told me that
he was saying, so that's what I'm referring to. I told you from the statement from Isaiah 9, he was referring about the spirit of God, the almighty God will be upon him. Yeah?
I understand that.
That's what I'm going now down to make this claim. Yeah, this is a statement Jesus made.
Okay.
He was claiming, who sees me?
See the Father.
You see the Father.
So correct me now,
so who hear me? Hear the Father.
Correct my understanding now.
So that's the authority of God, the Father who was upon him.
Okay, I understand now. So the people at the time of Jesus, they were able to see Jesus from inside.
Going
am I understanding correct or not?
No, you're getting lost.
Okay, I understand. If I say, if you see me,
you see,
what was he referring to? See what? See outside or inside?
It's not the physical thing that you are looking to.
What I'm looking at?
It is a spiritual nature.
But I can't see your spirit.
No, but that's if your corner is your corner.
But the people, okay, so the time of Jesus, they couldn't see his spirit.
Now
hear me out.
The
time of Jesus, were they able to see his spirit?
They saw the nature of God in him.
In what way?
They saw the power,
in what way?
Glory of God.
So when they were beating
because
him, that was Jesus, the Father
Jesus
of God.
Jesus took them in the mountain. He went to pray. And Jesus transfigured. He shone his glory. Basically, the physique he became like an angel. And he was shining. And Moses and Elijah appeared before him. Jesus became like an angel.
Angel is not
so
God.
He showed. But again, that's what thing you can never
can
understand.
Anyone understand?
I'm explaining to you the glory that was in Christ was hidden. He gave an opportunity to his disciple to see it. He went in the mountain to pray. He took them. And Jesus transfigured. And then the prophet, Elijah and Moses appeared before him. Jesus was no longer that.
Where did Moses appear before him? somewhere.
Transfiguration, you know transfiguration.
No, follow transfiguration.
Yes, that's what I'm saying.
But he said Moses saw him.
No, Elijah and Moses appear with Jesus. There were three now.
Where?
In the New Testament.
Moses appeared to Jesus.
Yes. Elijah and Moses appeared before him.
Before him?
Yes.
So what does that mean?
It's Jesus show his glory. Has not been
But Muhammad saw Moses
those are false. There are
terrible. Yeah, you false one. You want to
these are ten.
Why you want to okay, my wife?
These are witnesses.
Yeah, they're witnesses. Moses, Abraham, Noah.
Jesus too. Yeah, took John and Peter.
Alhamdulillah.
And they went to pray. They went to pray, and Jesus transfigured.
Transfigured to what?
He saw his glory.
Become angel.
Again, this is.
Yeah, understand me. No. Become angel.
I say he transfigured, he became glory. He was shining.
Doesn't mean he's God if he became shining.
It doesn't matter.
But our point is about being God.
Yeah, but that's what I'm bringing to you. I explained to you the Spirit of God from Isaiah 9, he was going to be upon this person who is Jesus, the Savior
of
the world.
It's not.
And he manifests that glory upon him. That's why even when he was speaking to them, he said clearly, who sees me sees the Father, and who hear me hear this voice. So he was making the same claim, according to Isaiah 9,
okay,
that the Spirit of the Father will be upon
so
him.
When the
that's what I'm
okay.
explaining
so
to
when
you.
Jesus said he doesn't know the hour, was the Father speaking?
I laugh.
Yeah, because you told
the
me
reason,
Jesus said,
no,
if you hear my voice, you hear the voice of the Father.
Yeah,
so we just said that's
have
not
to
the
laugh.
Hour. Who's the Father speaking?
Just hear me. I have to
laugh.
Because these are the little things. These are the little things fail you, which let you fail on the wayside. Because you cannot understand it. Because when Jesus resurrected, when he resurrected, the Bible is so clear.
Yeah, that's why.
The Bible so clearly said, now Jesus ascended to heaven and sit on the right throne of
power. That was my
power.
Question. When Jesus said,
I'm
I don't know the hour,
I'm bringing
was the
to
Father
you,
speaking?
I'm bringing to you. When Jesus, he died, resurrected, went to heaven and sit at the right side of the throne of God. And God says, sit until I make all your enemies my foot, your footstool.
Under your footstool.
Which is mean, God now, he has fulfilled his mission. God now, we will decide to
that's
send him
question.
Back. That's what I'm answering. God, the Father, yes, the Father.
Is he answering the question?
That's the Father. Listen, the Father will decide what time Jesus is going to come back.
And ask
so
you
that's
who decides,
clear.
Who decides?
That's what
you
I'm saying. That's
no.
what I'm,
my
that's
question
what I'm
was,
answering you. When Jesus said, no one knows yeah. the day and the hour, is the same thing. When he ascended,
who was speaking?
He's waiting now for the Father to give the order to come back now.
I understand that. Okay,
that's what I explained
but, to you. No, but I'm saying you said, when Jesus said, if you see me, it's the Father, and if you hear my voice, it's the Father's voice, correct? So when that Jesus said, I don't know the hour, was the Father
but
speaking?
That's what I explained to you. That's the Son was speaking, that Jesus
okay.
was speaking.
Look to Islam.
That's Jesus
wait,
was
watch
speaking.
This, watch this. Look to the simple and the best explanation. Allah sent the Quran, say, oh Muhammad. Oh, Amir,
Allah,
let me twitch my
the Quran is a lie. It's a lie. Which God will make a law for his prophet, benefit? Which is God, just to satisfy his sexual desires.
Okay, I'll come to that anyway.
Yeah.
To that. That is
and that's why you're calling God a prophet.
That's a lie. We'll come to it.
We'll come to it.
Allah sent the Quran, say Allah is one. Master.
But not the God of Israel.
Let me finish my point. Say, oh Muhammad, to them, we believe in the God of Abraham.
No, you
the
don't.
God of Moses.
We don't.
So now, hear me out.
You don't.
Now, hear me out. Let me finish.
If you believe in the God of Israel, you're not going to persecute the Israelites. And the Christian.
The Christian, they're good.
No, you're not going to do that.
Okay,
that. You're not going to do that.
Before you advise us, you advise your own Christians for killing the Jews in Spain. Okay? And
you conquer all this
okay,
nation
okay,
with Christians.
Before, no,
Islam went
can I finish
by
my point?
The soul,
finish my
to also, conquer this nation.
Yes.
So we have to
okay,
defend.
Wait. Can you tell us how East Africa became Muslim?
You conquered.
Anyway, let me finish.
You conquered his Allah, hand with your sword.
No, never.
Yes,
lying, never.
But false. Nah. It's the same thing you still
I think you're mixing between a Bible who enslaved the black people in Africa and between the Quran. There was no Quran and there was a Bible used.
Is Muhammad the hardest slave?
Let me finish my point.
As he had a slave.
Let me finish my point.
Is your prophet a slave?
Let me finish my point.
Exactly.
So Allah.
So you can't defend
him. Let me speak.
You can't defend
him. If you fail, in order for me to defend anything, you have to allow me to finish speaking. Right? Thank you very much. Now, logically speaking, if I want to judge this person, I should judge him according to his speech, not a media speech, correct? Now, if the brother Ali said, imagine to Ali, no, you don't work. And I say, I work. I said, no, you don't work because I feel like it. People say, hold a minute, the person is saying he works, but you say he don't work. If Allah clearly said to us, we believe in the God of Abraham, you said, no, we don't. Logic dictates how on the earth we don't believe. If Allah clearly said, we do believe. The other thing about Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, I spoke to him many times, original guy. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allowing him to have many wives with the legislation, same thing as the Old Testament. Who gave the authority for Abraham to marry more than one wife? Can you tell us who?
By himself. It's not God allowed him to take a wife.
Wait. So
there is no scripture saying God said to Abraham, go and marry many women.
So
there's no way.
Okay, was Abraham wrong for to have two wives?
No.
So okay.
It was his will.
So now if Abraham, when he got a second wife, why God never corrected him?
I'm saying that's God's
Okay, that's
answer. That's okay. In the scripture, there is no word. Yeah, okay, there's no word. That God condoned Abraham.
He does condone, he does. No, he does, because he blessed Hagar. If that was wrong, he should not bless Hagar.
That's what I'm saying.
Does God bless Hagar? Did God bless Hagar?
What I'm trying to say, yes. There is no verses in the Bible say that Abraham should get another one.
No, there is.
There is not.
No, there is not about Abraham.
There is not.
Let me finish my point.
God is speaking and saying to
Abraham,
get another wife or more wife. God never said that.
So God never said marry her?
God never said
that. So Abraham was following Satan, who was following God when he married her? No, answer back. No.
Do you understand what I'm saying? I'm saying
you know what?
Donkey
can understand Shamsi question.
It is not
but Christians don't understand.
No.
My question was to you, was God following Satan when he got married to Hagar, or was he following God?
He was following his free will, isn't it?
But was he wrong? Was he wrong?
He wasn't wrong.
He was right.
It was his own decision.
No, was he right?
He was not wrong. That's
no, was he right?
He was, within as a person, yes, he was. To make that judgment.
Because why? We know if he was wrong, God will correct him, correct? The fact that God...
It was not wrong because...
It was right.
I would say yes.
And of course, why he was right? Because God will not bless Hagar and he will not bless her son. The fact that God bless Hagar and bless her son, therefore, either your God is to a satanic teach a way of Abraham and never corrected him, or what Abraham did was right. That's why God went silent, meaning God agreed with him. So therefore, Prophet Muhammad getting more than one wife, there's nothing wrong with it. You understand?
Hear me out.
What I don't understand, excuse me, is your book a book of disgusting teaching or good teaching? Why are you God telling the Israelites to use human feces to cook with it? Silence. Allah Akbar. Thank you.
Where are you going?
You're talking. To you. Silence.
No, you asked me a question. You asked me a question.
So
is it something?
It's book. Is it teaching? Is it a book of cooking?
Sorry. I'm not aware of this verse.
I'll show you here.
I'm not aware of this
verse. I'll show you. When God telling the Israelites to use the human feces to cook food. Man, understand. So God, you have no problem.
What? It just burned them.
It's a book of God.
It just burning.
It's a book of God or a book of cooking?
It's just burning, isn't it?
Is it a book of God or is it a book of cooking?
They use feces to burn.
Human
to
feces.
Have faith.
Human feces.
Sorry.
Human feces.
But just
so
to
you have no
what?
Problem to. I mean, no,
it's
like,
just a fire.
So you have no problem.
There's nothing immoral.
Not to cook food with it.
There is no self
so,
immoral.
Let me understand that.
There's nothing immoral.
Okay, let me understand. So you have no problem to cook your food with the feces?
It's not immoral. Yes, there's nothing immoral.
You have a problem with that.
But there's nothing immoral.
What's okay? Which prophet did God say
it's
that?
Not immoral.
Is immoral.
Sorry.
Is that you?
Is immoral.
Who did God?
Is that you?
I should ask you. Are you saying? Sorry.
Okay, man. It's not a problem with that.
No. Ask me a question. Do you think it's immoral?
So sorry. Slowly.
You probably shouting at me.
Show us the question.